हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आज की इस वीडियो में हम डिस्कस करने वाले हैं क्लास 11 की बुक हॉर्नबिल के चैप्टर नंबर 2 से ऑप्शनल और एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन आंसर्स। स्टूडेंट्स, यह वीडियो आपके लिए बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट होने वाला है एग्ज़ाम की दृष्टि से। इसमें सभी वो क्वेश्चंस इंक्लूड किए गए हैं जो कि अक्सर एग्ज़ाम में पूछे जाते हैं। तो स्टार्ट करते हैं। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, रीड द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स एंड पुट अ टिक मार्क अगेंस्ट द करेक्ट। यहाँ पर जो क्वेश्चंस हैं उनके कुछ ऑप्शन दिए गए हैं आपको, और उसमें से आपको राइट ऑप्शन देखकर उसको टिक करना है। तो देखते हैं। क्वेश्चन 1, द नैरेटर अलोंग विद हिज वाइफ सन एंड डॉटर सेट सेल फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग प्लेस। अब ऑप्शन कौन कौन से हैं हमारे पास? प्लीमाउथ, केप टाउन, लंदन। तो राइट आंसर क्या है इसका? कहाँ से शुरू की थी नैरेटर ने अपनी यात्रा? प्लीमाउथ से। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, What was the name of the ship in which the narrator set sail to duplicate the round the world voyage? जिस शिप से नैरेटर ने अपनी यात्रा शुरू की थी उस शिप का क्या नाम था? And the right answer is Wave Walker. Next question, Who were Larry Wiesel and Herb Siegler? Larry Wiesel और Herb Siegler कौन थे? कौन कौन से ऑप्शन है हमारे पास? पैसेंजर्स, मिनिस्टर्स, क्रूमैन। तो इसका राइट आंसर है क्रूमैन। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, मे डे कॉल्स आर। मे डे कॉल्स क्या है? इंटरनेशनल रेडियो डिस्ट्रेस सिग्नल्स, सी वेव्स, मूवी सॉन्ग्स। एंड द राइट आंसर इज ए, इंटरनेशनल रेडियो डिस्ट्रेस सिग्नल्स। क्वेश्चन 5, द मैसेज ऑफ द लेसन We are not together is क्या मैसेज है इस चैप्टर का? ऑप्शंस देख लेते हैं। Not do any adventures, B teamwork wins any crisis, C to live always in a comfortable zone। क्या है इसका राइट आंसर? Teamwork wins any crisis। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, जोनाथन एंड सूजन आर। जोनाथन और सूजन कौन है? क्रूमैन, The narrator's niece and nephew, see the narrator's son and daughter, and the right answer is the narrator's son and daughter. Next question, where did they celebrate Christmas? Options, east of Cape Town, west of Cape Town, northwest of Cape Town, and the right answer is east of Cape Town. Next question, कैप्टन जेम्स कुक whom the narrator wanted to duplicate the round the world voyage made 200 years earlier was कौन थे? फेमस बिजनेसमैन, फेमस लीडर, फेमस एक्सप्लोरर। एंड द राइट आंसर इज फेमस एक्सप्लोरर। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, आइल एमस्टरडम वेयर द नैरेटर लैंडेड हिज बोट हैड नंबर ऑफ इनहैबिटेंट्स। आइल एमस्टरडम में कितने इनहैबिटेंट्स थे? ऑप्शंस हैं 30, 29, 28, एंड द राइट आंसर इज 28. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, हु इज द राइटर ऑफ द लेसन वी वर नॉट टुगेदर? कौन थे इसके राइटर? जेम्स कुक, गॉर्डन कुक एंड एलन ईस्ट, जी बी शॉ। एंड द राइट आंसर इज गॉर्डन कुक एंड एलन ईस्ट। अब हम इस चैप्टर से कुछ शॉर्ट आंसर्स टाइप के जो क्वेश्चंस हैं उनको देखेंगे। तो क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, व्हाट डिड द नैरेटर प्लान टू डू, व्हाट प्रिपरेशन डिड ही मेक फॉर इट? एंड द आंसर इज द नैरेटर प्लान टू गो ऑन अराउंड द वर्ल्ड सी वोयाज ऑन द सेम पैटर्न एज कैप्टन जेम्स कुक हैड डन 200 ईयर्स अर्लियर। फॉर द पास्ट 16 ईयर्स He and his wife had spent all their leisure time developing and improving their skills with work related to travel on the sea. Next question, give a brief description of the narrator's boat. How had the narrator equipped and tested it? क्या पूछ रहा है question? कि आपको एक डिस्क्रिप्शन देना है नैरेटर की बोट का, जो उनकी बोट थी जिस पर बैठकर उन्होंने ये यात्रा की थी जिसका नाम वेव वॉकर था, उसके बारे में आपको बताना है कि उसकी कैसे साज सज्जा की गई थी या उसको और उसका परीक्षण कैसे किया गया था. एंड द आंसर इज द नैरेटर्स बोट वॉज कॉल्ड वे वॉकर. इट वॉज अ ब्यूटिफुल 23 meter लॉन्ग 30-ton wooden hulled ship. It had been professionally built. They had spent months fitting it out and testing it in the roughest weather they could find. Next question. How long did the narrator plan his voyage to last? Answer. The narrator had planned his round the world journey to cover 1,05,000 kilometers in 3 years. Question 4. When and with whom did the narrator begin his voyage? Narrator ne apni jo yatra thi wo kab aur kiske saath mein shuru ki thi? Answer. The narrator began his sea voyage in July 1976. He had his wife Mary, 6-year-old son Jonathan and 7-year-old daughter Susan with him. They set sail from Plymouth, England. Next question. Whom did the narrator employ and why? When did he do so? Narrator ne aur apne saath mein kisko liya tha aur unhone aisa kyun kiya tha? The narrator employed 2 crewmen, American Larry Wiesel and Swiss Herb Siegler, in order to help them tackle the southern Indian Ocean, which is known as one of the roughest seas of the world. He engaged them before leaving Cape Town. Next question. What happened on their second day out of Cape Town? What worried the narrator and why? उनकी जब यात्रा शुरू हुई उसके दूसरे दिन क्या हुआ और किन चीज़ों ने नैरेटर को परेशान किया और क्यों? आंसर देख लेते हैं. On their second day out of Cape Town, they begin to face storms. These storms blew continuously for the next few weeks. He was worried about the waves. Their size was alarming. This rose up to 15 meters. That is as high as their mainmast. Next question. How did they celebrate the Christmas holidays? They were 3,500 kilometers east of Cape Town on 25 December. The weather was very bad. Still, they had a wonderful holiday, complete with a Christmas tree. New Year's Day saw no improvement in weather. Next question. What efforts were made to face the rough weather? Answer. In order to face the rough weather, the speed of the ship was slowed down. They dropped the storm jib. They lashed heavy mooring rope in a loop across the stem. Then they fastened together everything and went through their life raft drill. They attached lifelines, put on waterproof clothes and life jackets. Next question. What sort of wave hit the ship? How did narrator react? Answer. It was a mighty and huge wave. It appeared perfectly vertical. It was almost twice the height of the other waves. It had a very unpleasant breaking crest. The narrator had never seen such an enormous wave, so he was filled with horror. Next question. What was the impact of the torrent on the narrator and wave walker? Answer. A tremendous explosion shook the deck. The narrator's head struck the wheel and he flew overboard and was sinking below the waves. Unexpectedly, his head came out of water. Wave Walker was almost capsizing. Her masts were almost horizontal. Next question. How did the narrator manage to survive through the attacks of subsequent waves? Answer. One of the waves threw the ship upright. The narrator was able to reach its main boom. Subsequent waves tossed him around the deck like a rag doll. His left ribs cracked. His mouth was filled with blood and broken teeth. Somehow he found the wheel, lined up the stem for the next wave and remained firm. Next question. How did the narrator and the other members react to the presence of water in the ship? Answer. The narrator could not leave the wheel to examine the damaged parts. Mary shouted that the decks were broken and they were sinking. Larry and Herb were pumping out water like madmen. Sue had a big bump over her eyes, but the children said they were all right. Next question. I had no time to worry about bumped heads, says the narrator. What problem do you think deserved his immediate attention? Answer dekh lijiye. The starboard side had been struck open. They were taking in more water with every wave breaking over them. If he did not make some repairs urgently, they would sink. The narrator managed to cover the gaping holes with canvas and waterproof hatch covers. Next question. What problems did the narrator face during the night of January 2nd, 1977? Answer. The head pumps started to block up with the debris floating around the cabins. The electric pumps short-circuited. The water level rose threateningly. The two spare head pumps had been wrenched overboard. The waves had also carried away the foresail, the jib, the dinghies, and the main anchor from the deck. Next question. How did the narrator react to the problems? What does it reveal? The narrator did not lose his calm and courage in the face of problems. He thought calmly. Then he remembered that they had another electric pump under the chart room floor. He found it in working order. They were not getting any reply to their distress radio signals. He was not surprised as they were in a remote corner of the world. Next question. I didn't want to worry you when you were trying to save us all, said Sue. What had happened to her?
जब स्यू ने ये बोला कि मैं आपको और परेशान नहीं करना चाहती थी, तो वह क्या कहना चाहती थी, उसके साथ क्या हुआ था?
Sue's head had a bump. It had swollen alarmingly. She had two enormous black eyes. She also had a deep cut on her arm. She did not bother her daddy about her injuries as he was busy in more important task. Next question. Why do you think the narrator searched for an island so eagerly? Answer. The wave that hit Wave Walker had caused extensive damage. Nearly all the boat's main frames had been smashed down to the keel. A whole section of starboard hull was being held up by a few cupboard partitions. Wave Walker could not hold together long enough for them to reach Australia. So he searched for an island to repair the boat. Next question. Why could they not set any sail on the main mast of 4th January? Answer. The hull of the ship had been damaged badly. Pressure on the rope supported the mast and sail would simply pull the damaged section of the hull apart. So they hoisted the storm jib and headed towards the island. Next question. How did little Jonathan react to the desperate situation they found themselves in on 5th January? Answer. Jonathan asked his daddy if they were going to die. The narrator tried to assure him that they would overcome the situation. The little John declared bravely that he was not afraid of death provided they could all be together. तो स्टूडेंट्स, ये थे इस चैप्टर के कुछ एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चंस. इनको आप अच्छे से पढ़ लें,
एग्जाम्स में अक्सर पूछे जाते हैं। थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग।